Lights are visible. Students, am I
No,
audible?
ma'am. Yeah,
Huh?
ma'am.
The screen,
Yes,
ma'am.
ma'am.
Yes,
Okay, fine. So, last class we have discussed with this. Sorry, just a second. Just to give a revision of the last class. So last class we have seen the healthcare system at the rural level. At the rural level, what we have got? Three tiers. That is primary. So the primary level, what is there? The sub-centers and the primary health centers, these two are there. And then the secondary level of care, it is provided. Secondary level of care, it is provided at the community health centers, sub-district hospitals, and then the tertiary and district hospitals. And the tertiary level of care, that is a tertiary level, it is provided at the cities and the districts levels. Big hospitals and specialty care will be provided in this tertiary level. And the same structure is applicable for the urban area also. So the healthcare system at the urban area or the urban level. So here also we have got primary level, secondary level care, and the tertiary level of care. So primary level care in urban areas, it is mainly provided by the urban primary health centers. So the concept is very clear here. And the secondary level of care is provided by the which one? Urban CHC, that is urban community health centers, and tertiary is again by the big specialty hospitals. So this is if you see here, urban PHC or the urban primary health center. One urban PHC, it will serve for how many people? 50,000 population. And very important is that in urban primary health center or primary level, there is no sub-center. A question can be asked in this area also. There is no sub-center at the
Ma'am, there is no
urban
slide,
level.
ma'am.
Yeah, what happened, Roshan?
Not presenting, ma'am. Slides are not seen.
Slides are not seen. Just a second. Nothing problem. No, can you see the slides?
Yes, ma'am. Yes,
Slides are
ma'am.
visible. Fine. So urban PHC. So the urban primary health center, one urban PHC, it will serve how many people? It is beneficial to 50,000 population. And there is no sub-center at the urban level. Very important MCQ question. And in urban primary health center, like the people like apart from the other staff nurse and doctors and all, so contemporary or parallel to ASHA is USHA worker. So these are the USHA workers, so who are present at the urban level, and they will go and serve the slum population. And one USHA worker is for every 1,000 people to 2,500 population. Then we have got urban community health center. So one urban community health center will serve for 1.5 lakh population in the metro city, 1 to 5 lakh population. And whereas if it is a non-metro city, it will serve for 2.5 lakh population. And usually this CHC are provided with 30 to 50 beds. Are you all clear here? Just you have to know that in urban area, urban PHCs are present, urban CHC are present. Then there is no sub-center. Just like ASHA worker, here in urban area we have got USHA worker, and one USHA worker will be serving how many people? 1,000 to 2,500 population. Whereas one ASHA worker will serve how many people? Students, one ASHA worker will serve how many people? She'll be serving for 1,000 people.
Ma'am.
This number you have to remember it. Then if you see the urban primary health center staff, so usually MBBS doctor will be there. In that two MBBS doctors, in that one is full time and one is part time doctor. Then staff nurse, three staff nurse will be present. This number you have to remember because already some questions have been asked related to this staff nurse. And one lab technician, one pharmacist, and one ANM, that is auxiliary nurse midwife, and a clerk and support staff. So for us, the very important is staff nurse, MBBS doctor, and the lab technician. So these counts we need to know it. So as I told you that in urban area, just like ASHA worker, so one USHA worker will be there. So what is the function of this USHA worker? So Usha is nothing but urban social health activist. So the full form of this Usha is urban social health activist, and she has been started, this particular cadre has been opened during National Urban Health Mission. Under this mission, this Usha cadre or post has been created. So she will go to the nearby slums and she will provide the relevant health education, nutritional information, family planning, and she will also do the referral service to the slum and the nearby underprivileged people of the urban area. Now let us see some of the already asked MCQ questions related to urban primary health center and urban CHC. Can you all hear me, students?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. The question is, which of the following is false? Smriti, Prabhakar, Akarsh, which of the following is false about the staff at primary urban health center? So you should be careful in reading the question. So here he is asking about urban health center. So what is wrong? Already we know that staff pattern, 2 MBBS doctors are required. Yes. And in that, 1 full-time and 1 part-time, we know it. Then lab technician, 1. Pharmacist is 1. Then what about the staff? 3. Mm-hmm. What ideal number is? 3 is required. But here the option given is 2 staff nurses is enough. That is wrong option. So the false statement is which one, students? It is 4. D. Yes. Next question. Mobile medical care is provided service to all except. Now you need to know the concept of which one, students? Mobile medical care. What is this mobile medical care? So it is like in a bus or in a van, the essential services are provided. So to which areas this particular mobile medical care is indicated? It is actually an indicated for outreach activities, like very underprivileged or poor people, or people who are not having any accessibility to the healthcare services, who are living very much far away from the health center, so, and who are very poor and underprivileged. So for such people, this mobile medical care will be serving. So one vehicle or van will be there. So in that, the healthcare, one driver and one sister and one relevant house surgeon or doctor will be there. So they will go and reach the area which is far away from the what available health centers. They will reach there and they will provide the service for them. So now you should only logically think and answer here. Mobile medical care provides service to all except. So again, the question asked here is what? Except.
Tertiary healthcare.
Tertiary healthcare. Very good. Because primary healthcare, then secondary healthcare, and near home based. All these three are functioning at which one? Village or rural level. So the village or rural level, so these buses or mobile vehicles, they will go and provide the service. So at the primary healthcare, then secondary is nothing but CHC. So all these areas, it will go and provide. Whereas in tertiary, there is no need of all this, mobile service, because big hospitals are there and people can afford this tertiary healthcare. So the answer here is which one, students? It is tertiary healthcare. Any doubts?
No.
Next question. Primary healthcare involves all except. So again, the question asked is except. It involves all. So if you look at the options, it is something like what does this primary healthcare does? So if you know the functions of the primary healthcare or the elements, then say sanitation and safe water supply is one of the very important element of the primary healthcare. Do you all agree with this?
Yes, ma'am.
Then sound referral center. Look at the word here. So do you think that the primary health care, it will act as a referral center? No. The referral center,
no.
If you see, this primary health care can give a referral center to CHC, and CHC can give a referral to tertiary health centers. But primary health center, it will never act as a referral center. I mean, it itself doesn't act as a referral center. A sound, this word is very important. A strong referral center, no, because not many facilities are there. Then does the primary healthcare, it will provide the essential drugs? Yes. All the very basic drugs will be available over there. And health education definitely will be provided by the health workers posted over there. So the wrong option over here is which one, students? Sound referral center. Yes. Then an example for secondary healthcare level will be, so he is now asking example of secondary healthcare. So secondary healthcare, we already know that what all things are there in secondary healthcare, students?
CHC
is there. We have got subdivisional, sub-district hospital, district hospital. CHC. Then we have got sub-district hospital. District hospital. So usually these three will come under which one, students? Secondary level of healthcare. Yes, where some specialty services are provided. Now let us look at the option. Secondary health level care, he is saying that primary health center, no. Here only primary level of care is provided. That is very basic and essential care. So this is not the option. Subcenter is further below the primary health center. Here also no specialty care. So this is also wrong option. Then community health center, yes. It is a classic example for secondary health care. Then APE health institutions. These are like big, big hospitals. It is provided at the tertiary level. Now you people only should choose the answer here. Which one here?
CHC.
It is the community health center. Yes. Smriti, Guram and others. Roshan, Akarsh.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. Now just look at the picture here. The picture is an example of which principle of primary health care. Now look at this. What is there in this picture? Just observe this. What is this?
Water supply.
Yeah, water supply. And what is there? A raised cement platform is there. And the water tap is there, right? Water tap is present. Now here one ground or platform is there. Now do you think for what purpose it is utilized? So this we call it as what? Standing water pipe. Standing pipes. Water pipe. Now for what it is constructed? Like in a village. Yeah, tell me.
Appropriate technology, ma'am.
Yes, very good. Excellent. It is appropriate technology. How? I'll give you an explanation here. So for like this is a village and there is no like a common water supply to each and every house. Every house doesn't have a like common drinking water supply. Now what the government will think, if they want to install the water supply to each and every house, it will be very expensive, right? What is our ultimate aim here? Safe drinking water. Yes, safe drinking water is our ultimate goal. And to provide this safe drinking water, there are two ways or options for us. One is we can connect the pipes to each and every house, but it is very expensive. Very expensive, right? And the second option is this standing water pipe. Like in the center of the village where many people can accumulate there. So in that particular center of the village, you construct which one? You construct a water tap over there and people can come, open the tap and they can take this drinking water and carry it to their homes. So this is what is the standing pipe, water pipe. Now look at here, appropriate technology. What does it will say in one of the principle of primary healthcare? It says that we need to choose the technology in the right way. If you choose the first option, that is each and every house, if you supply the water pipe, it is very expensive for the government to bear it. But if you look at this one water pipe and it provides a safe drinking and it is very much cheap and government also can afford it. So here you need to think logically and wisely and choose that technology for the village. Yes? Do you all agree with this?
Yes.
So if you see the first principle, equitable distribution, no, it is not an example for equitable distribution. What is the meaning of equitable distribution? No geographic or no
social
caste, sex, economy. Yeah, yes, tell Roshan.
All social, demographic and economic, ma'am.
Yeah. So everywhere it should be equal. Now here what is happening? Geographic, like this particular standing water pipe, it is not useful for the adjacent village. It is only useful for the people who are living close to this water supply, right? So geographically some imbalance is there. If you see the another nearby village and little bit distance is there, they can't come and reach this particular area. So there is no equitable distribution for this. So this is wrong one. Then what about community participation? Here, like more than the village people, the government involvement is very much important here. Like government need to provide the fund, they need to give the water connection to this. So what the village people can do for this? So it is not appropriate to say it is a community participation. Then intersectoral coordination. Find some coordination is there, but the most relevant is appropriate technology. We have got different technology here, and in that the best technology we are using it for the population. So which is the right answer, student? Appropriate technology.
Appropriate technology.
Yes, because already this question has been asked once in NEET entrance. Next. This is the information which I want to give is that doctor population ratio, nurse population or nurse doctor ratio, and the ratio of one ophthalmologist. Now, if you see, ideally, WHO, that is World Health Organization, it recommends that in any country or usually in any region, one doctor should serve how many people? 1,000 people. So one doctor should be serving how many people? 1,000 people. So this is the ideal doctor patient or doctor population norm. So one doctor should be serving how many? 1,000 people. But do you think our India have achieved this particular 1:1,000?
No, ma'am.
No, ma'am.
No. Because still we are in a little bit deficient over here. So one doctor is serving somewhere around 1,600 patients. So still we need to reduce this number. So for this, furthermore, what collective efforts and work teamwork has to be done to reach this particular 1:1,000 target. Yes? Then the nurse population or nurse doctor ratio. It is recommended that 3 nurses is required for one doctor. So nurse doctor ratio, if the question is asked, nurse doctor ratio means what? Three nurse is required for one doctor. Required for one doctor. This is first point you need to know. Second thing is that if the question is asked, nurse per population ratio, then three nurse should serve how many people? 1,000 people. So you need to know these numbers. Already these guidelines are there. Why? What are these numbers? It means if there is 3 nurse for 1,000 people, she can provide the services very effectively. And the burden or load on her will be reduced. And the quality of care also will be what? It will be improved. So it has been observed that if there are 3 nurses for 1,000 population, then we can have a better quality of health care. Yes? Then ophthalmologist, the eye specialist. Yesterday, already I have discussed that there are 2 things over here. One eye specialist is required for 50,000 population. Look at the option. Or if the question says that one eye specialist is serving for 5 community health center. Both are correct only. Yes?
Yes, ma'am.
Already yesterday we have discussed. See, if eye specialist, just remember the mnemonic 5. Everywhere it is 5 only. See here, 50,000 population, one fellow will be serving or one doctor will be serving 5 community health centers. So these numbers you have to just remember. There is no other option. Yes? Now, we will just go through some of the health planning committees of India. So just I'll give you a brief outline and I will discuss the MCQs also related to this. Whenever we want to streamline the health system, we need to have some proper planning before getting it into action. And for that, some committee will be created. What is a committee? Committee is a group of people. So group of people. So together they will sit, discuss on one common point. And for this group, one big boss will be there. He'll be called as what? He is called as chairperson or the chairman of that particular committee. Now, different committees are there. Very important first one is Bohr committee. So already in the beginning class, I told you Bohr committee was established by whom? Sir William Joseph Bohr. So Sir William Joseph Bohr. So he was actually Indian only, but he was appointed under British government or a British Sarkar. And this particular committee was created before independence only in the year 1943. So now the chairman of this Bohr committee was Mr. Bohr, and he has taken how many years, students? 3 years. So over a period of 3 years, he has observed the Indian population and he has come out with a certain recommendation. that is in the year 1946. So like this particular Bohr committee is also referred by another name, that is Health Survey and Development Committee. Just remember this name. It is also referred to as which one, students? Health Survey and Development Committee. This word why I am underlying, you will understand it later. Because in further future committee, no, same word is given, Health Survey, but instead of development, it is named in a different way. So different word is utilized there. Now let us see the recommendations of this Bohr committee. He said that primary health centers has to be established in India. This is one of the very, very key recommendation. And in this, he has given two plans. One is short-term plan, another is long-term plan. It is also called as 3 million plan, because already entrance exam question has been asked on this 3 million plan. Now, what is this short-term plan? Bohr said that looking at our Indian health situation, one primary health center should serve how many population? 40,000 population. This is what he said, first point. What is the present scenario, students? Currently, one primary health center is serving how many people?
30,000.
By now, you should answer this. If it is in a plain area, if it is hilly or tribal area, how many? 20,000. Just one number less than this. 20. I mean, you have to remember this way. So Bohr has said that in a short-term plan, one primary health center should be established and it should serve 40,000 population. And he has given second option also, long-term plan. Like if you want to think of a health in a long-term plan, which is also called as 3 million plan. Why it is called as 3 million plan? Because he said that, I'll tell you, just listen here. One primary health unit, if it is established, it should contain 75 beds in it. Then secondary unit, that is our community health centers and all, it should contain how many beds? 650 beds. And tertiary health unit, where all this super speciality and speciality care is available, it should contain how many beds? 2,500 beds. And all these should be able to cater how many people? 3 million people of India. So during those times only, he said that if you want to serve the 3 million people of India, we need to have this particular structure. That is, at the primary level or the primary health unit, each unit should have 75 beds, secondary unit 650 beds, and if it is tertiary unit, then you need to have 2,500 beds, and all this will serve how many people? 3 million people of India. That's why it is also called as 3 million plan. Because he has planned this particular beds for serving how many people, student? 3 million population of India. Then he has also given very important concept, social physician. He said that there should be a new designation called as social physician. What is social physician? Again, MCQ has been asked on this. Akash, Smriti and Guram, Prabhakar and others. Students. Any idea, social physician? So, am I audible?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. So, social physician means Bohr has said that once you people come to internship, no, like after finishing final MBBS, once you reach the house surgeon or internship, then what happens in this internship during this period, 3 months posting should be compulsory of this PSM subject only. Now, how many months posting are there, students, for you during internship? Akash?
12 months.
No, internship 12 is 12 months, but community posting, how many months are there?
We have for two months, ma'am.
2 months. But yeah, others?
And 1 month of this thing. Yeah, 3 months only in total.
3 months, right? So this is what is called as the house surgeons who are posted in the rural area for 3 months in their community posting. And those people, they are called as social physicians. Yes, you people, that is only house surgeons, if they are posted for 3 months in the community department PSM posting, then they are termed as what? Social physician, according to whom? Bohr. So all of you finished your community postings, PSM postings. Anyway, during your house surgeon, when you come to this PSM postings of 3 months, that time you will be called a social physician according to Bohr committee. Then he has also given some idea about the school health. It's of not much important to us. And very important is that Bohr committee has explained about the comprehensive health care. So already I told you what is comprehensive healthcare. It is a provision of promotive,
preventive
and curative healthcare services from, this word is very, very important, womb to
tomb.
Womb, that is from the time of conception. The person is alive since the single cell, that is zygote stage. From then till the death of the person. So till then, you need to monitor this person. So that is from womb to tomb in a defined geographic area. In a defined geographic area. This is the what logic or the definition of this comprehensive healthcare. It was given by Bohr. Yes. Now let us see a question which was asked on this Bohr committee. So in one of the entrance exam, it was asked, 3 million plan was proposed by which committee? Now it should be there in your mind. See Bohr.
Bohr.
See, just remove this line, erase this. Then what happens? It will become three, right? Yes. So if you try to forget or anything, just remember Bohr committee, then 3 million plan. Bohr committee, comprehensive plan. Bohr committee, he told already about the PHC. So all this point you should remember. So the answer is which one, students? Smriti?
Bohr committee.
Bohr committee.
It is Bohr committee only. Now let us see this Balwant Rai Mehta committee, which was established in the year 1957, that is post-independence. Now, who is this Balwant Rai? Students, Gurram and others, Vani, Syed. Students, so Balwant Rai was the second chief minister of Gujarat state. He was the second chief minister of Gujarat state. Okay, then he was appointed as a chairperson of this Balwant Rai committee. And he was asked to look out the like health service infrastructure in the India. Then he was the person who has recommended for Panchayat Raj Institution, that is PRI. So he is also called as what? Pioneer of Panchayat Raj Institution. A question can be asked for you. Who is the pioneer of Panchayat Raj Institution? That is Balwant Rai Mehta. So what is this Panchayat Raj Institution? It is actually a three-level, administrative system. Like at the village level only. So at the rural level, three levels are created for the purpose of administration. So the lowest level, that is the village level, it is called as what, students? Panchayat. Just remember this, because many questions asked in relation to this. Then little bit above the village level, some better services are there, that we call it as what? Panchayat Samiti, PS, that is a block level. So Panchayat Samiti, it is little bit higher level, present above the village level. Then above this block level, we have got which one, students? District level. If you come out this block level, then district level. So for the purpose of administration, he has said that so like village level, block level, then district level. Then if you see this village level, now he has said that again in the village level only, you subdivide the village level into further three subcategories. What are they? Gram Panchayat, Nyay Panchayat and Gram Sabha. Remember this, village level is further subdivided into three levels, that is Gram Panchayat, Nyay Panchayat and Gram Sabha. Gram Sabha is smallest among the village. So if at all this is the village, in this village only Gram Sabha Panchayat will be there, Nyay Panchayat and the Gram Sabha. So this is the order how it goes. Now let us see some questions which were asked related to this Balwant Rai committee. Am I audible and clear to all of you?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
So now look at the question here. At village level, Panchayat Raj consists of all of the following except. Now he is saying that Panchayat Raj at the village level. Now he is saying at the village level. Already we have seen in the previous
slide,
Gram Panchayat, Nyay Panchayat and Gram Sabha. So Gram Panchayat, Nyay Panchayat and Gram Sabha, these three are present at the village level. We already know it, right? Now, at the village level, what is all are present except he is asking. Zilla Parishad, no, it is at district level, right? Zilla, that is the meaning itself, word itself says it is at district level. Then Nyay Panchayat, Gram Sabha, all these three belongs to which one, students? Village level, right?
Yes, ma'am.
So now what is the answer here? except means it is A, Zilla, A. Parishad. Prabhakar, clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, Smriti? Okay. Panchayat Raj includes the following except. Again, the question has been asked. So it is like Panchayat Raj, it includes all except. Now it includes which one, students? Panchayat Raj?
Naya Sabha.
Yeah, Naya Sabha, because it includes Panchayat Raj. Overall, it is, again, it's a generalized question. So at the village level, we already know Gram Panchayat, Nyay Panchayat, and Gram Sabha. So this Nyay Sabha is not included in this Panchayat Raj. So this is the wrong option. I mean, this is the answer which you need to mark it over here. So this is the answer for except. Yes? Clear with this?
Yes,
student. Just respond, no, everyone. Yes. Others, just excuse me. I'm like not familiar with your names. Yes, but kindly respond to me. Next. Renuka Ray committee. So who is this lady? She was actually an IAS officer. So like during the British government only, she was a very intelligent lady. So like she was, she has what cleared those in public service commission, and she was designated with that cadre. And if this lady name comes, just keep in your mind, Renuka means it is always school health services. This lady, Renuka. Renuka Rai committee means anything, everything, it is all about school health services. Like this committee was established in 1960, but the recommendations were given in the year 1961, that is after 1 year. And she always spoke about the school, that is guidelines for the school health service. And she also recommended that food should be given in the school for school children, that is meals. So we need to provide the food, because so that they'll get a balanced diet, and the even the poor people also get encouraged to go to the school because they are getting the food over there. So this serves two purposes. One is nutritional purpose is served, and very important is enrollment to the school will also be served. So she also suggested for provision of food in the school. Then she also recommended that medical examination of the school children, and it should be conducted with the parents' involvement. Yes? So Renuka Ray committee means just think that it is always about the school, because till now not question, I mean no question has been asked on this Renuka Ray committee, and I think maybe in your any of the future exam they may ask this question also. Now one more information. When was the first in which place the first school health service was started? Anybody from the place of Gujarat here? Baroda. So Baroda was the place where the first school health service was started. So just a pilot testing. The government has tested and started with the examination of the school children in the city of Baroda, Gujarat. Yes, just remember this name. Next, Mudaliar committee. So he was actually a doctor from this thing Karnool, Andhra Pradesh. So during that time, it was under Madras presidency. So now this particular committee is also called as Health Service and Planning Committee. Because in the Bore committee also, that time I have insisted you, Bore committee is also referred by one more name, that is Health Survey and Development Committee. If it is Development Committee, it is directly Bore committee, our Bore committee. If the name says that Health Survey and Planning Committee, then it is Mudaliar committee. Now, the chairperson of this Mudaliar committee is who? It is Dr. Mudaliar. Dr. Mudaliar. Now, what did he recommend? He said that one primary health center should serve 40,000 population. Now, don't you remember that same recommendation was given by Bore also? Yes, same thing he has said here. Now, this Mudaliar, Dr. Mudaliar, he also said that just like Indian Administrative Service, IAS, let us also create an administrative examination and post for the medical doctors also. That is All India Health Services. Question has been asked on this. Just remember this. AIHS. His committee recommended that just like IAS, AIHS cadre has to be created in India. Then he also said that we need to strengthen the district and specialty services. So very important is the second point, that is creation of All India Health Services. Next, another committee is Chadda committee, which was started, or it was created in the year 1963. Now, very important thing here is that this particular committee, why it was created? It was created to give any recommendations on the maintenance phase of National Malaria Eradication Program, because during this period 1963, this National Health Program was going on, that is National Malaria Eradication Program. I will discuss all these programs detailly in each and every class. So in this program, it has come to the maintenance phase, and this committee was given the work, like you just discuss and give recommendation for this particular program. Now, what is this CHADA committee recommendations are? They said that the vigilance or the monitoring activity of this National Malaria Eradication Program should be carried out by whom? Basic health workers. So he said that a new post, a new non-medical post or paramedical post has to be created, and that post name has to be by the name Basic Health Worker, BHW. And one basic health worker should serve how many people? 10,000 people. So what is the function of this basic health worker? He said that this basic health worker, he need to actually participate in the National Malaria Eradication Program. Then he should also perform his duties in family planning, and also he need to record the vital statistics. So what are vital statistics, students?
Infant mortality. Yeah.
All this birth, death, all this registry, whatever the events happens in the life, no, in that given area, that has to be recorded. So record maintenance. Then this basic health worker also should also function in family planning. That is, he should go to the families, encourage them and educate them about the small family norms and make them a responsible citizen. And even he should participate in the National Malaria Eradication Program. So this was a recommendation given by the CHADA committee. So basic health worker, if the question is asked, it was recommended by the CHADA committee. Next, Mukherjee committee. It was given in 1965. Remember, students, 1963, the CHADA committee, he said that the basic health worker, who is nothing but a multi-purpose health worker, this fellow has got a multiple task. Like he has to participate in malaria program, he has to participate in family program. Even this fellow also has to record vital statistics. So workload is what, students? Heavy workload. So because of this, what happened? This one person, he was not able to give 100% effective performance to all these things. So if he is working on malaria, he's not work well for the family planning or other thing. So what did this Mukherjee committee said? That better you de-link this basic health worker from the malaria activities and family planning. So you create separate person, separate health worker for family planning, and create a separate health worker who will carry on with the malaria program, National Malaria Eradication Program. He said just dealing, separate these activities. So malaria ke liye, malaria activity karne ke liye one person, and to take care of the family planning, one more cadre has to be created. This is what is the important recommendation of this Mukherjee committee. Yes, clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. Now, he is very, very much important. Jungalwala committee, 1967. If you see all these committees, 1963, 1965, 1967. So in the 60s, only many important health committees have come. Yes? So 63 mein who has come, students?
CHADA committee.
Huh? 63. CHADA committee. Then 65? Mukherjee
committee.
Then 67, Jungalwala committee. Now he said that we need to go for integration of health services. Like don't create any separate things. Let all the health department come under one respective unit itself. Like if there is a small health unit, another health unit, don't keep separate departments for that. Let all the health be managed by some Ministry of Health, something like that. So an integration of the health services under only one cadre. Then he also said that common seniority, then recognition of extra qualification. For example, MBBS doctor is there and there is an MD doctor is there. Now he is saying that you give additional recognition to this MD doctor and pay more for this MD doctor as compared to that of the MBBS doctor. For example, if the MBBS doctor is paid 50,000, then you pay 70,000 for the MD or specialty doctor. So equal pay for equal work and extra qualification, you just recognize them, and then special pay for special work. Any special work like extra OBG, like deliveries are conducted, any special work, or if they participate in national health programs, give additional incentives for them. And very important is that this committee recommended abolition of private practice by the government doctors. Very, very important, because already MCQ has been asked. It is said that no government doctor should do a private practice. Now in India, at least 70%, this is already seen. Yes, do you all agree with this? Still, there are many government doctors who do their own private practice. So this was the committee which first time recommended that abolition of the private practice by the government doctor. And he said then improve the already existing service. Now look at the question that was asked. Integration of health service was first proposed by students. Now you should only answer this. Students.
I'm board committee.
No, integration of health service. Just now I told you, no?
B.
Jungalwala committee. Which one? Yeah, who said this?
Prabhakar.
Very good. Yeah, excellent. So it is this fellow, Jungalwala committee, he said that we need to integrate everything, all the health comes under one particular section. Bore committee, remember, he spoke about the primary health care, primary health centers. Then he spoke about the comprehensive health care. Yes, comprehensive healthcare. Then he has also spoken about the 3 million plan. So these things you need to remember about the Bore committee. Don't get confused. Yes. Then Kartar Singh committee. It was established in 1973. Now from 60s, we have switched on to 70s. So in 1973, very important committee. It is also called as committee on multi-purpose worker. And some MCQs has been asked on this Kartar Singh committee also. So this committee, it recommended that the government need to create a post called as multi-purpose worker, MPW. And this multi-purpose worker should be posted at the PHC. Or they should be posted at where? Any health center. And they also recommended that one PHC should serve at least 50,000 population. Yes. And they also said that one male and one female health supervisor, they should be appointed at the community health center. So just you have to remember in Kartar Singh committee is that multi-purpose worker. Multi-purpose worker means what? It is Kartar Singh committee. That is multi-purpose worker. Yes? Clear with this?
Yes, ma'am.
Next, Sri Vatsava committee. So in yesterday, in one of the slide, I told you that at PHC only, Rome, reorientation of medical education. That is reorientation of medical education. This is a full form of which one? Rome. So what does this Rome? It says that this is a recommendation given by the Sri Vatsava committee in 1971. This particular committee, it entirely focused on the medical education, like what was the medical education system existing during 1970s and how we need to improve that to serve the Indian public effectively. And so that's why it is also called as Group on Medical Education and Support Management Committee. Remember this name also. So very important recommendation is reorientation of medical education. According to this, what they said that three primary health centers should be linked to one medical college. That means one medical college should be attached to how many primary health centers? Students? It is three primary health centers. Am I clear and audible to all of you?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. Then he said, he also recommended for the introduction of village health guide. Already we have seen, now it is not there. And he said that we need to create a post of health assistant at the primary health center. And he also said that this is very important. A band of semi and para professionals post should be created in India. And he also suggested that a committee separately has to be created on medical and health education. So this particular Sri Vatsava committee, it is like more focused on which one, students? On education, medical education. And this committee also gave the concept of referral service complex. So what is the meaning of referral service complex? Again, look at the pyramid or triangle here. This is a PHC or sub-center. So it is like, if you can't provide the service here, kindly refer the patient to higher level center, that is community health center. If not, then refer the patient to tertiary level health center. So this particular thing is called as referral service complex. So this particular idea was given by whom? Sri Vatsava committee. Now let us solve some MCQ related to this Sri Vatsava committee. Question has been already asked. A group on medical education and support manpower was popularly known as. Now students, listen here. Medical education, our education group means it is always which one, students?
Sri Vatsava
committee. Yes, it is Sri Vatsava committee. Health workers, this point you have to remember here. Next, Krishnan committee, very, very important. Now from 60s, we have come to 70s, then 70s after that, we have come to 80s, 1983. So this Krishnan committee, very, very important. He said that, please don't only focus on the rural area, even our urban area is also affected. So like, have you all heard about 2-3-4-5 syndrome of urban area? What is this 2-3-4-5 syndrome of urban area? I think I'll give you this as a homework for you people only. Just try to find out and let me know. Because of this syndrome only, the government has decided that yes, we need to create some urban health centers also. At urban level also, we need to create a three-tier healthcare system. That is what this particular syndrome has led to, the creation of urban health system. So this committee said that in urban area also focus has to be given and we need to create urban health centers like urban PHC, like different cadres we need to create. So if a question is asked on urban healthcare system, Krishna committee, you remember. Then Bajaj, a strong committee. Remember this, where like many times the question has been asked, Bajaj committee, again 1980s only, that is 86. This committee was created and the committee was mainly focusing on the manpower. That is like, for any program to run, we need human beings or the manpower. So we are deficient at the like people who are working for this national health programs or the health services. So less number of doctors, less number of paramedical staff and all. So this committee recommended that we need to create a policy where how to tackle and like how to manage this manpower, they have discussed in this particular committee. So this committee said that only we need to create the policies related to medical health and health education and manpower. This is very, very important. Why I'm stressing anything which I stress, remember that it was already asked and it may be asked also in the future exam, right? Now we will come to our 2000, our present generation, very recent one. That is in the year 2011, high level expert group committee, that is HLEG committee, very, very important. This committee, it said that we need to create universal health coverage. I think if you remember in the beginning itself, I told like what is universal health coverage? It is for everyone, everywhere, everyone, everywhere, because if at all any disease is there, whatever the income the person has saved or earned, everything will be spent on curing this particular health problem only. So because of that, the person is becoming what? Poor, or he is landing up into which one, students? Poverty. This is what the people have understood, like administrative people have understood. So now to tackle this poverty causing because of this health issues, this universal health coverage concept has come. And as a part of this universal health coverage, what is the scheme which we have? The biggest health insurance scheme of the world, that is Ayushman Bharat. Like what is this Ayushman Bharat? It is like added health services are provided where geriatric group, dental or oral health services and many other added health services are included in this Ayushman Bharat, apart from the existing health services. Along with that, insurance coverage, health insurance, like 5 lakh per family. So per year, so that particular like financial burden is also tackled, and healthcare is also like what it is also covered. So that what is happening, we are trying to eliminate the poverty and we are trying to improve the health. And if the person is healthy, he can lead to the buildup of the very healthy and productive nation. Yes, are you all clear with this,
student? Yes, ma'am.
Now, based on this committee only, our national health policy, National Health Policy of 2017 has come into existence. Remember this. National Health Policy, first time, it was started in which year, student? 1983. So this Krishna Committee is there, no? During this period only, the first National Health Policy of India was started. Then second National Health Policy, it was started in 2002. That is somewhere after 20 years. Our government said that, okay, we will do one more national health policy. Like they have checked how many infants are dying, how many newborns are dying, how many mothers are dying, maternal mortality. So all these statistics they have collected, and they said that looking at this, they have created one health policy for the improvement of Indian health situation. Now, after all this, then again in 2017, that is somewhere after 14 years, right? The third national health policy has been come into existence. This third national health policy, sometimes they can also say that 2015, don't get confused, even this is also correct, because in the year 2015, the present government, during this tenure only, this particular national health policy has been drafted. It was drafted, but officially it was published in 2017. And this present national health policy, it mainly focuses on this universal health coverage. If you don't know, don't remember anything, remember that universal health coverage is a key core concept of this third National Health Policy of 2017. Yes? And yes, I think this particular committee also recommended that a 3-year bachelor of rural healthcare post, like after your MBBS, you have to work in rural areas for 3 years. That was proposed by this particular committee only. Now it is no more existing also, because it has become a hectic job for everybody to accept it. Now let us see some of the questions here which were asked. Are you all clear with the health committee, students?
Yes, ma'am.
So no doubt. Yes, ma'am. So first and foremost, bore, bore, bore. Just remember, started with the boring person, and it is a very important person, and he started with the 3 million plan, primary health care and comprehensive health care. Don't forget Renuka Rai committee. Why I'm stressing, because no question has been asked on her committee, and probably you may get a chance to attempt her question. Renuka Rai committee is related to which one, students? Students, Renuka Rai committee was related to school health
service. School health services.
Don't forget that. School health service, that is the main concept of Renuka. Yes, lady means she was more attached to the what? Children. Just, at least remember that way. One lady, she is more attracted towards the children, so that's why she spoke about the school health service. Just remember this and don't forget her. Now let us solve some of the MCQs. Universal health coverage of India was recently approved by which health committee? Now just
high level expert.
Yeah. Now you should only answer. I should not say anything. Which one, students?
High level expert.
High level expert group.
Yes, now you should not forget anything. Everything, you should only manage this. High level expert group. Yes, which year, students?
2011.
Yes. Now, Bajaj. What did I tell? This fellow, Bajaj, if he comes, a very strong fellow, he always speaks about manpower, manpower.
Manpower.
So, if you don't remember anything, manpower is always related to our Bajaj committee. He spoken about policy making on manpower and policy making on medical education. That is Bajaj committee. So Bajaj committee of 1986 proposed on which one, student? Manpower. Yes. So this integrated health service, this was recommended by JW committee, Jungalwala committee. What you do know, students, after this class, open your PARC textbook, read this chapter once, twice, thrice, or as long as you can picturize and memorize them. Yes, then you can attempt all this. Then multi-purpose. Multi-purpose means what? Katar Singh committee. Yes, fine. Then yes. Rural health service, it was proposed by Balwant Rai Mehta Committee. Now
yes,
remember, just a small information I want to give you. Balwant Rai, I told you, no, he was the second CM of Gujarat, right? Second CM of Gujarat. And he was killed by the Pakistan people. Like his plane was going. So he was sitting in the plane with his wife and he was traveling. And Pakistan army people, they felt that it is some enemies they are intruding into their country. So they didn't know that this good person was sitting in the plane. So they just attacked and bombed this plane. And this Balwant Rai and his wife and the people who were in the plane, they were all killed in that plane crash. Yes? So this is just information for you. Next, Bajaj committee. Again, the question has been asked on this Bajaj committee only. Bajaj committee, true. Just to see the question here. Was it constituted in 1946? No.
No, ma'am.
It was in 80s only, 1986. 1983, which one? Krishna. Krishnan committee was established in 1983. And it spoke about urban health center. Then Bajaj committee, did he recommend for formation of primary health center? No.
No.
Did he recommend for health manpower? Yes. Manpower
yes,
means
yes.
It's always Bajaj only. BMW car, that is very strong one. Bajaj manpower. Just remember this. Yes. None is not related to here. So what is the right option here? It recommended
C.
for which one student? Bajaj committee manpower
C.
policy. So just stick for this thing. So should I stop it here or should I continue tomorrow or how do you want? Students? Can I get response from you people? Students? Tarim, Salman, Prabhakar, Vani, Akarsh, Smriti. Am I audible or no? Tell me, students.
Yes, ma'am.
Shall I continue? Or do you want me to post it tomorrow?
Ma'am, tomorrow.
Tomorrow?
Tomorrow.
Tomorrow, my question.
So tomorrow I'll continue with this. So what time is convenient? This 9 o'clock is okay for you all or how it is?
Yes, ma'am.
Ma'am, 6 o'clock. Ma'am, 6 o'clock is fine.
6 o'clock? Not a 6 o'clock.
Late, 6 late ho jata hai.
Not
6. So I'll continue. Huh? Yes, Prabhakar, 6 o'clock. I mean, we'll conduct at 6 o'clock. Vani and others.
Yes,
six
ma'am.
Done, right?
Yes, ma'am.
So 6 o'clock, I'll continue with this one. Health management techniques. Yes.
Ma'am.
Tell Roshan.
Tomorrow classes. Care or not?
Yeah. So what do you want me to do? Tomorrow sir also will be taking class. Or shall I continue after sir's class? As per your recommendation only.
It's a, I think it's ma'am little bit question is there. To complete
this one, right? Community.
Yes.
So shall I continue now?
So you can continue, ma'am. Just otherwise, it's a small portion is there left in our total whole chapter.
Okay, students. Others also agree with this. I'll go ahead with this now. Akarsh.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. I'll continue. Just a little bit is there. Okay. Smriti, Prabhakar and all, just listen here. I'll anyway proceed with this. Okay. Health management. Now here, health management is like before we conduct with any health program, we need to know how to manage it. So what is the basic meaning of management? So management means what? It is a purposeful and effective use of resources for fulfilling the predetermined objective. Am I audible for everyone?
Yes, ma'am.
Ma'am.
Okay. Now thing is that if you feel that, if I say this statement, do you think it is okay? No, it is not fine. because malaria eradication means, like, as an administrator, I will say that I want this particular thing to be done. Done means it should be done. Now, to get this malaria eradication, I need to see that how the things has to be done or which all things to be used and how they should be properly kept so that this eradication of malaria can happen. So that is what we call it as what? Management. In management, we effectively utilize the resources. What is the resources? Money, material, and manpower. Three M's. So resources means R is always related to M. That is money. How much money is available? Based on that, you need to plan. Then material. What all items, laboratory facilities, all those things are there. So just look at all those. Then you have to plan your program. Then money, material, and manpower. Like for conducting this program, are the people available? So that is what we call it as manpower. So how effectively we make use of this to get the thing done, that we call it as what? Management. And to manage any particular thing, certain techniques are there. So we need to know if at all a task is given to Roshan, like, or Akash or Smriti or any of you, Guram or Prabhakar, like if I say that I want like 100 people in this area to be what tobacco free, they should not to use any tobacco. Now that was a task given to you. Now it is your work that how you will fulfill that task. For that, what you will do, you will see that how much money I have, then who are all people are available for me to fund this, assist me. Then how much time, all those things are there. So all these parameters, you only sit and analyze. So those things we call it as what? Technique. So different techniques are there. One is cost benefit analysis, that is CBA. So cost means what? We will see input, then output. So input means what? For the running of any program, we put what? We put some money. We put what? Some money. Yes. For example, National Malaria Eradication Program, government has spent maybe some 100 crores. Yes. Now, after completion of the program, maybe like what happened? The government has saved how many? 200 crores of the money. That means what? Many people have got cured of this malaria. And since they got cured, they were able to attend their jobs and they were able to do a lot of work. And that lot of work has been added to the productivity of the country. And this has led to the improved economy of the India. So that means what? Here the benefit, whatever is there, is measured in terms of money. Like if I put this much money, how much benefit I am getting? That we call it as what? Cost benefit analysis. Now, do you think that is it good for our health field? Like any program, if we do, can we measure it in terms of how much money I saved in this program? Do you think is it logic for that? No. But the logic will be there for any program. If I start with a program of tuberculosis, how many lives are saved or how many deaths have been prevented? If this is the final outcome, then it is good for us, right? That we call it as what? Effectiveness. Now, very important is that input, output. Input is cost here, how much money I have put, and output is how many lives or the lives have been saved from that particular event or the disease. So that means what? In cost effectiveness analysis, the effectiveness is measured in terms of which one? The results. The results. Whereas in cost benefit analysis, the results are measured in terms of which one? Monetary. The benefit is measured in terms of monetary or money wise. Now, as a health professional, for us, this cost effectiveness is suitable. Like we can always say that if I have invested 100 rupees on this program, 1,000 people lives have been saved. That means what? This particular program is effective. Yes? Clear with this?
Yes, students? Ma'am.
Yeah. Then what is input-output analysis? This is nothing but a combination of our CBA and CEA. So that is cost-benefit and cost-effectiveness together. We call it as what? Input-output analysis. Like if I have invested this much amount or money, like how much profit or benefit I am getting out of this investment or how many lives have been saved, that we call it as what? Input-output analysis. Next, system analysis. What is this system analysis? It is nothing but comparison of two or more cost-effective alternatives. For example, like a drug A is there and drug B is there. Now, what is the thing is happening? Using this drug A, what is happening? It is able to reduce nearly 50% of the tubercular cases. And drug B, it is able to reduce 60% of the tubercular cases. So all this TB positive, they will become TB negative. If they use drug A, it will be 50%. Drug B, it is how much? 60%. But what is the cost of using this particular drug? Maybe drug A, each drug, maybe it costs around 5 rupees, example. And drug B, it costs around 30 rupees. 30 rupees. Now you compare these two drugs. Both the drugs are used for which one, students? TB management. Yes, for the cure of tuberculosis. Now, what is happening in that, which is most effective? Like here, 50% cure rate is there. In drug B, 60% cure rate is there. But when we look at the cost, for 5 rupees only, we are getting a drug which can cure 50%. But for 30 rupees, I am getting a drug which can cure only 60%. Okay, now, in these two drugs, which one will I choose now, students?
Ma'am,
A.
Because it is a logic, for lesser amount, even at least 50% some better benefit I am getting. So this is what we call it as system analysis. System analysis means what? You are comparing two things, two or more things. You can compare with as many as possible. So your comparison is done for the effectiveness. How much effective that particular what program or drug or item is giving. So based on that, logically, we will choose one of the item. Among the items that were compared. So the question has been asked on the system analysis. System analysis means comparison of cost effectiveness. Then we call it as what? System analysis. Next. Network analysis. Very, very important here. So network means what? It is a graphical or diagrammatic representation. So graphical representation of how the like health program events has to be taken care. And it has got two components, PERT and CPM. You need to understand this. What is this PERT? Program, Evaluation, Review Technique. What is PERT, students? It is Program, Evaluation, and Review Technique. Yes?
Now,
I'll just give you one example for this. One diagram is here. Now, for example, as a program officer, I want to conduct a program, and for that I have recruited this staff. That was the first event, and then I have given the training to this staff. Then after that, what happened simultaneously, as a program officer, I have ordered for the equipment. Then I have ordered, then later I have got that particular equipment or instrument. Then what happened? I have started with this service. This is one thing you have to remember. So in this network analysis, there are two components. One is PERT, another is critical pathway. That is, some it is not writing here. So anyway, just listen here. So in the first stage, what happened? I have recruited the staff. Then second stage, I have given the training to the staff. Third stage, what did I do? I have ordered for the instruments. Then fourth stage, what happened? I have got the instrument, what delivered, then I installed. Then after that, finally, I have started with the program. That is the last stage. Now what happened in between, to get the staff recruitment and training, I had to contact some regional people who already know about that work. So for that, what did I do? I have contacted the regional people, and these regional people, they have given the training to these people. Then meanwhile, I have contacted some funding people to get this particular instrument. So I have contacted these funding people to get this instrument installed. Now, ultimately, what is the thing? A network or sequence is created here. Now, what is the next thing? It is an arrow mark diagram. Now, in this, we have to put the timeline also. That is, from the start of the program till the recruitment of the staff, I at least required 2 weeks of time. How much did I require? 2 weeks. Now, from the staff recruitment till the staff got training, at least took another 3 weeks of the time. Now from staff recruitment, then I have gone with the what instrument order. So maybe I took 1 week for ordering and another 4 weeks for the instrument to be installed. And in between what happened, I have contacted this already trained people. So to contact them and get the training for this staff whom I required, some additional 3 weeks I took. Then to get the training completed, totally another 4 weeks. Then I have contacted this funding people. So maybe some 2 weeks I took over here. And to get all this funding and everything done, another 3 weeks was required. So now what is this PERT? It says that it is an arrow mark diagram, that is sequence of events that is happening. And then what is the important thing is that critical pathway. So critical pathway, it is nothing but the longest pathway. Longest pathway. Now that is what, and it is a very important pathway. It is the important pathway. That is, in this chain diagram or sequence diagram, you see which is the longest, I mean the longest pathway. Longest pathway means the pathway which it has taken longest time. Longest time. So what you have to do, just see here. So this is one pathway, A, B, C, D, and this E, that is program started. Imagine this is the one pathway for this program. The second pathway, what has happened? Once I have got the staff recruitment, I have gone into the another direction where I have found the people who can train the staff, right? Yes or no? So this is the second pathway. Yes. And what is the third pathway? It is from here, then after got the staff, then I have started finding for the people who can fund me. So this is the third pathway, which was there. So now what you do is like each pathway, how much time it was taken. So if you see this particular one pathway, then the second pathway, it was in this particular direction. And third pathway, it was in this direction. Are you all getting it or no?
Students? Yes, sir.
No confusion, right? Fine. Now each pathway, you add on the time. Like in this straight pathway, what was the time was taken? 2 weeks, then 3 weeks, then 1 week, 4 week. So like if you add how much? So 9 weeks approximately I required if I wanted to go with this first pathway. Then second pathway also you calculate the time like this. If it is gone in this direction, maybe overall some 5 weeks I'll be using. And if at all, if I go in this particular direction, maybe like 7 weeks were required. So, and here 9 weeks are required. So now in this, which is a critical pathway, the pathway which it required more amount of time. So that pathway, we call it as what? Critical pathway. That is the longest pathway and it is a very important pathway. And if any problem occurs in this path or in this event, then what will happen? Entire your program sequence of plan will be collapsed. It will be disturbed. Are you all clear with this?
Yes, ma'am.
So this particular thing, we call it as what? Network analysis. Network means what? It is a graphical representation of the sequence of events that are happening. So in this, two components are there. One is PERT. PERT means through arrows, we will just show the sequence of events, how they are happening. Then another is critical pathway means it is linked to the time. Like how much time is taken in each pathway, and the longest time taken of that path will be called as critical pathway. And any problem happens in that pathway, all your entire program will be disturbed. So this is about network analysis. Yes. Fine. Next is cost accounting technique. So cost accounting technique, what do you mean by this? For example, if I got 100 crores of amount, and if I have given this amount to the some national health program, in that how much amount is split for each component? That is for to get the drugs, maybe 50 crores are given or spent. Then to get some equipments, maybe another 20 crores are spent, and another 30 crores are spent on which one? Health workers. So that is what cost accounting means. What? Out of the total amount, how much amount is distributed for the sub-components of that particular program? That we call it as what? Cost accounting. Then zero budget approach. Already MCQ has been asked on this. What is this zero budget approach? So zero budget approach means, if you remember, the financial year of India, it will start from 1st April and it will end from until which one? 31st March of next year. This is what we call it as financial year of India. So now what is the thing is that, so government, if any program it has to conduct, it will provide the money during this particular April 1st only. Whatever the amount or the budget it has to give for that program, it will give on April 1st only. So maybe 100 crores it will give for that particular program, and you need to spend this 100 crores till March 31st. If at all, if you did not spend, some amount is left, maybe some 20 crores are left unspent, then what will happen? For the next year, the government won't give any additional money for that same program. It will say that you spend all this amount, then only I will give the further new amount. So that is what is the concept of zero budget. Zero means you clear all your money which was already funded to you and get it to the zero level. That is zero level. For this program, if 100 crores is given, make sure that you have spent all the 100 crores, then only a new amount will be granted for you for that particular program. So that is called as what? Zero budget approach. Yes? Clear here?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. Next. Work sampling. Again, MCQ has been asked on this. What is work sampling? It is like in our PHC, CHC and all, what will happen? They hire authority people. They will come. They will check us and they will monitor us regularly on periodic intervals. So it is nothing but how properly this particular doctor or paramedical staff, they are functioning, or how the sister is functioning, or how this overall entire health unit is functioning. So that is what we call it as what? Work sampling. That is means systematic observation. Some higher authority person will go, he will observe that particular area, then he will record the findings of that observation, and then in the then he will submit the report. What is the plus and minus points of the particular area which he has observed, and this observation will be done periodically. So that we call it as what? Work sampling. Yes. Then in health management technique, one more technique is there, that we call it as SWOT analysis. So this SWOT is a abbreviation form. So when we try to elaborate it, it will be like this. In the SWOT analysis, S stands for what? Strength. So for example, a National AIDS Control Program only. So like strength is like, we are able to tackle the reduce the number of AIDS cases. So that is the strength of the program. And weakness is still the stigma is there in the minds of the people. If somebody is AIDS, or they won't be revealing their high risk behavior also. So some type of stigma is there. So because of which we won't be able to come to know the actual cases, or we won't be able to identify the risk behavior of the person. So that is what is the weakness of the program. Then opportunity means what? Lot of research is going on this in the field of AIDS only, maybe new drug or vaccine trials. So many new things are going on. So lot of opportunities happening in this particular program. Then threat means what? Maybe we don't know if the virus is not working for that particular drug, or some resistance has developed, then we call it as what? Threat for that program. So SWOT analysis means what? Where we check for strength, weakness, opportunity and threats for that particular program. Clear? Clear with this?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. Next, we will solve some of the MCQs related to this management techniques. So let us see. Time taken for any project is estimated by time taken. So now he is talking about what? Time. So if you remember in the network analysis, so in that part is there program evaluation review technique. Then after that, we have got critical pathway. So what is this critical pathway? How do you calculate this critical pathway? Based on time. So
time.
For each stage or each step of your health program, how much time you are taking, and which step of the health program longest time you have taken, that longest time will be what? Critical pathway. Now, time taken for any project is estimated by which one, students?
Network analysis.
Because this critical pathway is a component of that network analysis. Yes, clear with that?
Yes, ma'am.
Fine. Next, all are true regarding critical path method, except now again he is talking about our network analysis only. So critical pathway, all are true except it is a part of input output analysis.
No.
It is something different only. Then a critical path method visualized in graphical representation of all the events.
Yes.
Yes, graphically already we know that some arrow marks we draw each stage, whatever we are doing, how much time we are taking, through arrows we represent it. So it is a right option, right one only. Then critical pathway is the longest part of the network. This is also correct. Then any delay in the critical pathway, it delays the whole project, right? So the part where longest time is taken, and there if any problem happens, everything will be disturbed. So this B, C, D are all right options. I mean, that is correct for critical pathway. Now he is asking except. So for this, you need to tick this one. It is a part of input-output analysis, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Next, PERT technique. PERT is a technique of which one? Now it is very much simple. It is a technique of network analysis. Now it is a straightforward question. No further confusion only. All others clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah? Fine. Next, true about zero budgeting. So zero budgeting, already I told you, until and unless you spend all your previously allotted budget and make it to zero, no new further amount will be given for that program. That is the concept of which one, student? Zero budgeting. So now options are given. True about zero budgeting. It relies on the data of previous budget. I think it is correct only. So in the previous budget, whatever the amount is there, so based on that only the next fund will be released. Yes, if the money is not completely spent, little amount is left, no new amount will be given. So the true about one is this, A is correct. Then other three, they are not the related to the zero budgeting. So the answer you need to tick over is A. Next.
Yes.
Systematic observation and recording of activities of one or more individuals carried at predetermined interval. So just now I explained to you that it is nothing but work sample. That is, in the working area, the people, person will be going and he will observe how this doctor is functioning and how many OPDs or how many surgeries or managements he is doing. Then they will also check for all the paramedical staff, how they are functioning, attendance, building infrastructure, facilities. So all those observation, we call it as what? Work sampling. And it will be done at the regular interval. Analysis done for expenditure of large proportion for small number and vice versa. Students, analysis, am I able to, are you all able to hear me?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. Now here, this question is related to inventory. It is related to inventory, that is related to stock. So for any like a primary health center or community, instruments are required. So all these stock items, gloves are required, then bandage, gauze piece, so many materials are required. So all this material management, we call it as what? Inventory management. So now in this inventory management, one of the technique is what? I'll just explain you about these techniques. Just look at here. One is ABC analysis. So ABC analysis means A stands for always, B stands for better, and C stands for control. C stands for control. So always means what? For example, always this particular drug has to be present in our health center. Example is that, even though its quantity is less, it is always based on number of items and the amount, that is a cost or the budget. So number of items, for example, in our PHC, we need this particular drug only 10%. The quantity required is only 10% and the cost is very high. It only takes up 70% of the cost. Example is corticosteroids or anti-snake venom or any cardiac related drugs. So what the thing is that even though at the primary health center and CHC, their requirement is not much, but still it is always required. If at all a snake bite case comes, then what will happen? If you don't have the anti-snake venom, what will happen? The person cannot be saved. That means what? Even though their requirement is less, but still they are very costly. They are not very cheap. They are expensive and you always need them. So such type of drugs or items, we call it as what? Category A. Always they are required. Then B means what? That is, even though they are present or not present, it doesn't matter for us. So it is like 20-20. Like 20% of the drugs are constituted by the B category of drugs, and they are a little bit cheaper as compared to that of the A category drugs. Then what about C? C means all our paracetamol, aspirin, and albendazole, all this comes under C category drugs. That means they are most frequently utilized or consumed, and they are needed in very high quantity, nearly 70%, and they are very cheap also. They are very cheap also. That means what? This particular type of stock analysis is called as ABC analysis. That is where we analyze which particular drug or item is required based on the quantity, that is number of items, and based on the cost involved in that particular item. So quantity and the cost. So when we weigh or when we check, measure these two, then we call it as what? ABC analysis. Now look at the question here. Analysis done for expenditure of large proportion for small number and vice versa. Now what he is saying, expenditure means what? That is the cost or the budget. Then number, that is the quantity or the how many items are required. So we are comparing these two. This particular one tablet, it costs 10 rupees. And if at all any alternative tablet is there, so tablet B, it costs me just 5 rupees. So I will weigh these two, then I will give an order for that. So this is called as what? ABC analysis. So just tick the answer ABC. Others I will explain you further. Next, VED analysis of the inventory control technique. So VED, students, are you
yes,
getting
ma'am.
Okay.
Yes,
you
ma'am.
Didn't get the toxic levels, right? Fine. So VED analysis means what? Here V stands for vital drugs. That means what? This drug should be always present. Like for example, adrenaline. Adrenaline is a life-saving drug in case of anaphylactic shock and all. So all yes. your PFC and all, even though they may not be used regularly, but it should be always present. So that means what? V stands for vital drugs. Even though their quantity requirement is less, that is only 10% of the drugs comes under vital drugs, but their absence cannot be tolerated. That means what? As a medical officer, you need to see that always this particular drug always should be present. If it is not there, you cannot manage the case in case such case will come. Then essential drug. In this VDE stands for essential drug. So they nearly constitute 40% of drugs. And if they are not there, okay, you can tolerate for some time. So for example, doxycycline or tetracycline, they should be there. Suddenly, if the shortage has occurred, fine, you can tolerate and go for an alternate combination of other drugs. And what about D? D is what? They are desirable. Like nearly 50% of the drugs are D. That is paracetamol and aspirin and all D category drugs. And even if they are not there, you can tolerate for very long time. Paracetamol is not there, give diclofenac. If not diclofenac, then give aciclofenac. So whatever alternate is there, you can keep on giving to them. So very important in any health center, vital drug. It should be present, and desirable drug not present also, it is not a headache for you. If the stock is over, then you can ask the pharmacist to give an alternate for that. Yes, this is what we call it as VED analysis. Clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. Akash? Next. SDE analysis. Are you all there or?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. Now, SDE analysis, what is this? S stands for scarcely available drug. A stands for available with difficulty. E stands for easily available drugs. That means, again, here also, it is also a different type of stock management, that there may be some drugs, like IV line drugs and all, some equipments or instruments, they are not readily available. You need to put the inventory for that, and it should be accepted. You need to get it from the production site. So a lot of time will be taken to get that particular drug. So such drugs we call it as what? Scarcely available drug. Then available with difficulty, that means you will get that drug, but you have to search here and there to get that particular drug. Easily available drug means what? Anywhere, any agency, if you go also, you'll get that particular drug. So this particular analysis, we call it as SDE analysis. Now FSN analysis. In this FSN analysis, F stands for fast moving items. So example is which one, students? Fast moving is our paracetamol only. Any headache, fever, paracetamol. One dolo, yes, it is a fast and fastest, quickest moving drug. Then slow moving drug. What is a slow moving drug? Maybe our antihistaminics and all. So like whenever the season is there, or rainy season or winter allergic season, that time it will move. Otherwise, no. Then non-moving drugs, like nobody usually, their movement is very rare. Maybe anti-rabies vaccine. So some drugs which are like, they'll be there, but they are not much used or consumed. So these drugs are called as non-moving drugs. Next, SOS analysis. In this SOS analysis, S stands for seasonal drugs. Seasonal drugs, like for example, ORS sachet. It is commonly utilized during summer season. Then our antihistamines, they are commonly, most commonly utilized during the rainy season or allergic seasons. Then off-seasonal drugs, like any season, our paracetamol. Anywhere, dolo. So there are certain categories of drugs. As a health officer, you should know what are off-seasonal drugs and what are seasonal drugs. So according to that particular season, you need to indent those particular drugs at a higher amount so that their deficiency won't occur. Yes? Now let us solve some of the question here. In management of stores, VED, D stands for what?
Desirable.
Desirable. V stands for what? Vital. E stands for essential drugs. Desirable. Stands for desirable. Are you all clear with this?
Yes, ma'am.
So in this VED, D stands for which one, students? Desirable. Yes. Next. In primary health care, ABC and VED are related to what, he is asking. We already know these two are related to what? Inventory. Inventory means what? Stock. Like how much drug is required or how much that particular injection or vaccine. So this is what, as a medical officer, you need to take care of all these items. So it is related to which one, students?
Drug inventory.
Drug inventory.
Drug inventory.
So just mark this answer. Next. It is a general question. Principal unit of administration in India.
Village.
No, Akash, it's not village.
No,
see, India, states and all are there. So then each state will have just, each state will have what? District.
District,
yes? So this district will form what? Administrative unit. So what is the administrative unit of India? It is nothing but?
District.
District. Yes?
Yes, ma'am.
Following are the pillars of primary health care except pillars. That is nothing but the principles or the core things of primary health care. So what are the principles of primary health care, students? Equitable distribution, then community participation. Best example is all our health workers. Asha, Usha, Asha, yes. All these people are there, no? They are all, yes, best examples for community participation. Then intersectorial coordination. This is also one of the principle of health education. Then primary health care. But this health education is not the principle, but it is
the element
of the primary health care. So now, except he is asking, so all are pillars of primary health care, except it is straightforward question, health education. Yes?
Yes, ma'am.
Next. Population of 1,000 is covered by, that means 1,000 population is covered by whom? Anganwadi worker, remember, they only cover very less number of people. They
only
400 to 800, that's it. They'll cover only very small section of people. One, yes, Anganwadi worker will serve these many people. Health assistant. They,
yes,
are present at where, students? At PHC. That means what? One health assistant will serve nearly 30,000 population. So this fellow will be serving lot of people. Yes. Then trained dai. This dai, what she will do? She will again serve. One dai is for 1,000 population, and yes, village ma'am. Health guide. One village health guide is also for
1,000.
Then one asha is also for how many students?
1,000
only. So asha, these people they serve 1,000 people. Whereas our usha, how many she will serve? This lady, she will be serving more than 1,000. That is 1,000 to 2,500 people. Usha means little bit urban, so little bit higher end she will be. So asha means little bit lesser end. So asha, trained dai, village health guide, they'll all serve for 1,000 people. So what should be your answer? 3 and 4. Next. Sub center in hilly area caters to a population of, again it's a repeated question only. So same thing, sub center, plain, and we have got which one? Hilly area. So if it is a plain area, she will be serving for 3,000 people. And if it is, 5,000.
Hold up. 5,000.
Yeah, 5,000. Then if it is a hilly area, she will be serving how much? 3,000. So now the question asked is hilly area. So it is 3,000. Next. One PHC is located for a population of
30,000.
Straightforward question. Now, emphasis shifted from urban to rural service. Now, urban to rural service. That means what? Equitable distribution. That means what? Government is saying that health services are mainly concentrated in urban area. Now, let this health services be more focused on rural areas. So, we want to equalize the urban and rural areas in terms of health service. So it is an example for what? Equitable distribution. Next. Number of ASHA visits of home delivery is. So this anyway, I'll take it in the national health program. So just remember here, ASHA worker, what she will do once the delivery is over, especially if it is home delivery, she will give how many visits? 6 visits. She will give how many visits? So lady is there, she has delivered the baby, one baby she has delivered. Now what will this ASHA worker will do? So this ASHA worker, she will go to her house on day 3, day 7, day 14, day 21, day 28 and day 42. If it is for which one students? If it is for
home delivery.
Institutional delivery. If it is home delivery, one more additional day is required. That is day 1, same days again. Day 3 she will visit, day 7, day 14, day 21, day 28 and day 42. I think you can remember the 3 table here. So if it is a home delivery, she will give how many visits students?
7.
It is 7 visits. If it is an institutional delivery, then she will give how many? 6 visits. Now remember, the last day of visit is 42 in both the areas. Yes. Now, if it is home delivery, on day 1 she will visit. If it is an institutional delivery, she will visit on day 3 onwards. Now, why only till 42 days she will visit? What is the reason for that? Yes, students. Students,
yes.
Why ASHA worker has to visit the this one postnatal visits for only till 42nd day? Because most of the studies have shown that within 42 days, if any maternal death has to happen, it will happen within 42 days. Most of the maternal mortality because of the postpartum hemorrhage. So most of the maternal deaths usually occur within 42 days. So that is the reason the ASHA worker will give a home visit to this delivery people within the stipulated days. So now the question asked is what? Home delivery. Home delivery means 7 visits will be there. If it is an institutional delivery, how many visits will be there? 6 visits will be there.
Six.
Now what is the answer here?
7.
Fourth one. Yes?
Yes, ma'am.
So this completes entire thing. Yes, So what all we have seen, students? Smriti? So what all we have seen till today? Like we have covered with the healthcare system or healthcare delivery of India. So basically we have spoken about urban and rural and urban area, that is primary level, secondary level, and tertiary level of care. And primary level, we have seen all that PHC, sub-centers, then CHC tertiary level, then urban health center, all those we have gone through, and we have solved the MCQs also. Then we have covered one more topic, that is health planning committee. So all those different committees and related MCQs. Then we have also like health program management. So all those management techniques, inventory techniques, everything has been covered. So any doubts here?
No, ma'am.
Student?
No, ma'am.
So now what you can do is like you can go and solve the MCQs. Yes, you can solve all the MCQs.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. Vani, is it clear for you?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Just go through all the things and solve the MCQs. I think that should be done. Fine. So tomorrow, sir will take the class at 8 p.m. Fine.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay, fine. So we'll meet tomorrow.
Thank you, ma'am.
Yeah.
Thank you, ma'am.
Yeah, thank you. Bye.